Good morning, rhinos. Welcome back to another episode of Crash TV. Today is Monday, November 7th, and it is an evens day. This week's show, you can look forward to a counselor semester grade check-in, the new season of Fortnite, a fundraiser at Old Town Pizza, exciting news in sports, and more. Now get ready, because Crash TV starts now. Rhinos, if you're interested in college or having a career you want to go into, keep your eyes and ears open because there's going to be a college and career fair at the very end of November from the 27th through the 30th. Next week is Thanksgiving break, and plenty of us are starting to stress about how finals are coming up, as well as cramming in as much homework as we can. And the semester is starting to come to an end, and plenty of us are wanting to keep our grades up. Let's see what our counselors have to say to keep our grades up.
My name is Cesar Valderas. I'm new to the school. I'm one of the school counselors here, and my alphabet is any kids' last names that start with G-O and go through O-N. We have Ms. Baird here, that is the alphabet for anyone A through G-L, and then Mr. Kelly, anyone with O-P through Z. So we have three counselors here. Well, I think with the semester coming to a close, we have about 6 weeks left. One of the things that keeps coming up is grades, final grades, right? We just had quarter grades come out not long ago, and we've done some of the things, interventions needed to help kids bring their grades up, like holding some check-ins and referring them to tutoring, looking at some of the flex times options and using those things. And so those are some of the things that kids should be utilizing right now, is attending tutoring, which happens after school. Utilizing flex times correctly. As fun as it is to go do board games and hang out with friends in the library and those kinds of things, I think visiting a math class, chemistry, whatever you're struggling in, and utilizing those resources and the teacher's time and support is something that's gonna be crucial for those end of semester grades. A lot of kids don't realize this, but those grades are final. They're gonna go on the transcripts. And if kids are hoping to get into colleges and be eligible, they're definitely gonna wanna make sure they have passing grades, C's are better at least. And then if they're hoping to play sports in college, or they're looking for scholarships, if they're looking to get into prestigious schools or competitive schools, they're definitely gonna wanna consider the fact that these transcript grades are gonna be crucial when it comes time for college applications. So if they need any support, they can reach out to their counselor or the administrator. We can kind of point them in the right direction, but some tools that they, or resources they already have, are using flex time properly, attending tutoring, communicating with their teachers, asking some what assignments they can be working on, asking what areas they should be focusing on, and preparing for those finals. Because at the end of the day, I think we only have about 6 weeks left in the semester, which is gonna come up pretty quick. If students need help, come out, reach out. We got you guys, and go Rhinos, woo!
Recently, Fortnite has been a hot topic. Liam has asked around campus what people's favorite part of the new Fortnite season is. Let's take a look.
Metro! Metro!
If you've ever played video games, then you have to know Fortnite. The game has made a huge comeback recently by implementing original features like old maps and weapon rotations to coax retired players to return to the scene. Recently, it seems like everybody's been playing. Even the most unlikely gamers have hopped on in hopes of securing a dub. We went out onto campus to go look for some gaming veterans, and it didn't take very long.
I'm here with
Anthony Tavelli.
Conley. And so you know how last this past weekend they updated the Fortnite map back to the like 6 years ago. How much have you been playing?
I've probably been playing like 2 hours a day.
2 hours a day.
Me quite a bit. I've actually stopped my gambling addiction to start spending my money on Fortnite.
Yeah, so I see you bought the Battle Pass then.
Of course.
What was your hot drop back in the day?
Pleasant Park.
Did you land there your first time back in?
Yep.
I'm here with
Isaiah.
And fellas, you guys been running in Fortnite lately?
Yeah.
Just downloaded it.
Okay, right on. He's getting back into it. At what level are you at, bro?
I'm like level 30.
He's been going crazy, bro. What about you?
I don't even know, bro. I had to make a new account.
A Hey, but you've been loving the pump and the scar, huh? That OG rotation is the best.
Yeah, I like it.
As you can see, everybody's back on and they're loving it. So hop back onto your Xbox, download the game again, and give it a shot. You might enjoy yourself. Good luck, gamers.
You know what pairs well with playing Fortnite? Ordering some Old Town Pizza. We here at Crash TV are holding a fundraiser on Wednesday, November 15th, where 15% of the purchases go back to our program. All you have to do is say fundraiser day when ordering. If you decide to stay in, just type FR15 when ordering online. Eat some good pizza and support Crash TV.
What's your name?
Hosea.
All right, Hosea, do you think pineapple belongs on pizza?
No.
Why not?
Because it's nasty.
What's your favorite pizza topping?
Oh, I like barbecue chicken.
All right, who am I here with?
It's EZ. All
right, do you think pineapple belongs on pizza?
No.
Why not?
That's just disgusting. It's like a fruit on a pizza, you know?
Yeah, what's your favorite pizza topping then?
Probably like bacon.
Bacon?
Yeah.
All right, thanks, EZ. Who am I here with?
Mr. Kent.
All right, Mr. Kent, do you think pineapple belongs on pizza?
In my opinion, I do not believe that pineapple belongs on pizza.
If you don't think so, what is your favorite pizza topping?
Sausage and steak.
Together or separate?
Separate.
If you don't think so.
I'm so excited to go eat some pizza later on this week. I'm even more intrigued to see what's going on with sports this week. Let's see what Matt Henry has to say for sports. Take it away, Matt.
Welcome back to the Sports Report with Matt Henry. This week in sports, we have our boys soccer playing at home versus Woodland and girls basketball playing Dixon at home on Wednesday. Friday, we have our boys basketball playing away at Stagg. This past Thursday, our football team followed up a historic undefeated season with their first playoff game opponent, Rosemont High School. Daniel Rivas was there and has a look back on the game.
Because I will tell you this, that Big 12 Bridges team from Marysville, right? They were really good. And it's going to be up to you guys to go out and play a better game tonight. Can you do it? That is the question. Can you play a better game tonight? Get us in the next round.
Metro Boomer wants to play a little.
Look for more information on future playoff games this week on Schoology. If you've captured any amazing photos from the playoff game, please send them along to the email on your screen and we'll feature them on future shows. Wrestling is holding a fundraiser for Christmas trees. They have 3 different types of trees and 4 different types of wreaths to order. Today is the last day to place your order. Pickup will be December 1st at TBHS from 12 to 5:30. Let's band together and support our wrestling team. Hopefully when this airs, we'll be talking about wins from both the 49ers and the Kings. And maybe the Chargers, because that's my team. That's it for sports this week. Now on to my favorite weather boy, Luke, for weather.
Good morning, Rhinos. I'm Luke Medeiros, and welcome back to your 7-day weather forecast. Taking a look at the forecast for this week on Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, we can expect rain all 3 days. Temperatures in the mid to low 60s. And then towards the middle and into the weekend of this week, we can expect still low 60s, mid 60s towards Saturday. And last week, unfortunately, we couldn't get Brielle Ford's photos in this broadcast, so we will throw them on the screen right now for you. If you have any photos that you want to be shown in this forecast or in one of our future forecasts, make sure to send them to the email on screen. Other than that, back to you.
Hope to see all you guys following our Instagram. Crash TV is officially reopening a new reinvented version of Furry Friends. You can send videos and photos of your pets to the email below. We are very excited to see what pets come in this time around. Now on to everyone's favorite segment, Crash Tags.
Yo, what's up? It's your boy, SAP Roman. If you don't know what SAP stands for, it stands for Substitute Assistant Principal. I heard my knees have to be in the shot, so Ms. Toff, these knees are for you. We got three winners coming up to you today. Number one, Ariana Romero, congratulations. Number two, Vanessa Watson, congratulations. And number three, Steven Pagano. Great name, because it's my name too. Not the Pagano part, but the Steven part. Congratulations. Stay tuned next week. There might be some more crazy shenanigans from Mr. Roman. Peace.
That's the end of this week's Crash TV. Thank you so much for joining us. Hope to see you all on next week's episode. Have a great week, Rhinos.